Okay, team, we're in one of the more pricey areas of Hampshire, and we're off to Andrew Smith and Son Auctioneers. They've got an auction coming up, and there's nothing in the auction from the trade. Everything in there has come from local private houses, which is a very good thing considering the sheer wedges of cash that are down here.
Yeah.
So I thought it was well worth a look.
I like an auction.
I love an auction.
They always do nice cake.
They do, don't they?
Yeah.
Not all of them have that, you know.
Do they not?
No.
Why do you go to the ones without cake? What's the point?
Established in 1793, this is one of Hampshire's premier auction houses, specialising in fine art, with 13,000 pieces going under the hammer every year.
Hi, morning.
Good morning.
A register?
Yes, sir. Would you like to go on one of these points, please?
Can I just say, got your number.
Oh, thank you. Right, let's get a coffee.
Cheers.
The advantage of an auction like this is that there are 500 lots up for sale all under one roof.
This is lovely. Running a very smart shop here, chaps.
The disadvantage is that he only has 1 hour before bidding starts to identify his target items and decide what he's prepared to pay.
I like to view everything myself. I don't like going off photographs because you never know. You can't stick your head underneath it on a photograph.
You wouldn't think that eyes were so many different shapes.
Mm. What's the estimate on these?
1 to 1.5.
There's a lot of them, isn't there?
Yeah, and they're all there.
Unusual to have that many.
Yeah.
You want to watch that? You have your eye out.
I knew he wouldn't be able to leave it.
I did try. I made an effort.
This is a really good rural auction house. A little honey hole of stuff. They don't take trade lots. So as a dealer, I couldn't walk in and say, look, can I chuck about 50 things in here and get rid of them? They don't do that. They're quite selective. And we are in an extremely wealthy area, and all of the pieces come from private homes. Bosh, that's why we're here.
With the clock ticking, Drew's already bookmarked at least one outstanding item.
This is a bit special. We're having this, if at all possible. I think the prize in the room, actually, is that it's a pollard oak writing table. It's pollarded oak and Fruitwood's original handle, single drawer, absolutely exquisite thing. It's got really good London maker. It's an extremely well-made, very beautiful, subtle piece of furniture. Do you know what I can see this making? $2,500.
Really?
With so many choice pieces for the picking and under pressure to stock the warehouse, Drew's developed a strict auction room strategy to make sure he only gets quality items.
I can go in as a general dealer and just go, oh, there's 50 quid in that, there's 100 quid in that, bam, 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 and pick up the cheap lots, but I don't want to. There's a few things in here that are well worth my time to sit down there all day and wait and see if we get lucky. Let's get comfy. Two comfy chairs, please. The auction looks very quiet. But there's 700 registered to bid online. That's the power of the internet and the antiques world.
First up is the lot Drew identified as the day's star piece.
The small writing desk. Lovely condition, no alterations, no ring marks, no cutting down, nothing wrong with it at all. That's a superb piece.
This diminutive aesthetic movement desk is constructed in oak and ebony with Fruitwood banding, manufactured by B. Taylor & Son of London in the 1870s and completely original and unrestored. Drew thinks he could sell it on for at least £2,500.
Start me at £400, £400, £400 in the room, £420 on the net, £450, £470, £500.
I always fake a sort of boredom with the whole process because it gets them to hurry up and I want them to knock it down to me.
1,000 and 50, 1,100 and 50.
I don't really do it on purpose to be nasty. I just want the piece. Now, the other guy on the end of the phone, I don't care who he is. If I want it, I'm going to have it.
And we're selling at £1,300. Is there any more? At £1,300 in. Are you all done at £1,300? The very last time.
Get it. the figure in my head that I would have paid was £2,500 plus the commission. I was more than happy to pay that. Literally, that is a 10 out of 10, that one. I'm hugely confident in that piece. And I think for £1,300, I've absolutely nicked it. I think it's wonderful.
Drew's off to a flying start, with one top quality item under his belt. Next up is something a little less stylish.
There's a very plain pine chest of drawers. It's had the life kicked out of it, this thing. This I like.
Yeah. It's junk, but look at that big names carved all over it.
Ex-Winchester College boarding house.
Gotta have it.
Loads of fun. Multiple carved names.
It's covered in names and vandalism, old period names scribed into the top of it. It's charming. And then T says, actually, look, it's from Winchester College. It's from the boarding houses. Great.
This pine chest of drawers dates to 1860, when it was supplied to Moorshead Boarding House at Winchester College. The names and dates carved by former pupils, known as Old Wickhamists, add to its character, and it could be worth around £580.
A split second, I saw it, so I'm having that. Really unusual. It just, you know, takes you back to some kid there, probably by candlelight, you know, scratching his name into the top of it.
Start me at 150. 150. 150 I have, straight in, thank you. Is there 160? At £150, any more? £150, last time.
It's excellent.
Bit of luck, finally. Just go straight in, just people off. Get in. It just really speaks to you as such a lovely history, great condition, really usable, and wasn't a lot of money.
670, 700.
He's got two great pieces in the bag, but when it comes to bidding, Drew's remaining disciplined.
150 on the net, 160.
He's sticking to the game plan and waiting for the quality lots that most appeal to him.
Oh, look at that. Lovely.
I'm having this.
There is a large leather painted room screen, profusely painted and very colourful. A decent sized house, though, well. Right, and cover a whole wall, and it's great fun.
This six-fold room screen is Italian and features hand-painted country scenes on a leather background. It probably dates back to the 19th century and could be worth around £1,500.
What I liked about it, running all the way through the middle, there was, like, hens and birds and animals and people all over it. Really nice scenes. Great size. Really tall.
There we are. Magnificent thing.
Come on, I want this.
I'm going to start the bidding here at 320.
Let's go straight.
Recording, did I say now?
Let's go straight.
304.